Hello, it's British Legion, and I have got something really exciting today. My good friend at Dark Ops, the company that make highly detailed MDF terrain, sent me a pre-release copy, a review copy of the Dungeon Saga Deluxe Dungeon Tile Set, which is amazingly excellent. And what you get 12 sheets, which I'm going to show you in a minute, of highly detailed laser cut MDF sheets. And it's officially got licensing from Mantic as well, which is excellent. And it will be on general release in January this coming month through Mantic's Pledge Manager. Also through Mantic's main website and also Dark Ops' main website store. So that's awesome. And it's going to recommended retail price is going to be about 50 quid, which is highly worth it in my mind. Awesome. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to show you the goodness.
2, 5, 7, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Right, here we go. As you say, we get 12 tiles, and this is one of the base tiles with the base plates on. So on top of these base plates, you can put your individual tiles on in random patterns or how you see fit. Some base panels are like is a set way of doing it, which I'll show you in a sec. But I just want to show you some of these tiles. The detail is amazing. That's one of the the individual square tiles that you put on the main baseboards. And there's another one. Some of the tiles I've already used, as I say. But yeah, you get 12 of these sheets. And then these are the components that I've laid out in formation. So you get quite a few of each. That's one I've done as well at the top there. And this is one of the set pattern ones. This is the Dwarven King's throne room. Really nice. The raised column areas. And the throne room at the back is you can make it detachable for packaging or travel. And that's made up in a few layers. And that fits in nice and snug at the end. And then the plastic throne goes on top from the actual game. This is the other second one. This is the Celtic rune floor tile. And the cross at the top is actually on one sheet, so it doesn't get confusing to lay that configuration out. It's really easy. And I do suggest that when you lay these out, you actually sort of dry fit them first, and then you take each one off and glue it on. It's a lot easier, and you won't make a mistake then. You actually get some measuring sticks as well with this kit, which is really cool. There's some sewer sections, which are really nice. And some other bits and bobs I've made up that I'm slowly putting together. And after this next video, well, the next video, I'll see if I can get some stuff painted for you to look at as well. So, yeah, awesome, awesome sauce. Right, they're all done. Finished them all off. And I haven't painted the rules. But I will paint them at a later date. And also the circular shield puzzle. I haven't painted that either. But I've concentrated on all the panels. They're all done. They're all painted to my standard. And I hope you like. What I've done, I've taken some static shots of two groups of them all together. I can't get them all on the same shot frame. And then what I'm going to do, I'm going to whip them home to my house and lay them out in a dungeon style formation, so you can see how they look and how they go together, because they are really, really good. I love them, and I've really enjoyed doing them. So thanks again to Black Ops for sending me this review copy, much appreciated. So I hope you enjoy the rest of the video. See you later.